Let's get it.
I don't smile. I don't frown.
What? Damn. You ready to give a nigga a headache, huh? You ain't. Bro, you just. Bro. Can you gather your rhymes or something? Can you be like, like you just, I don't, what? Slow it down.
Let's go.
I don't smile, I don't fret.
Yeah, I don't even give you a second to fucking, he just jump right in there, huh? Ain't no fluffing. He get right in there. He'll get right in there. All right, okay.
I don't smile. I don't frown. Get too up or get too down. Yeah. I was here, so were you. You came and went. I stuck around. Yeah. Still here now.
Wow. He wasted no time at all. And to the casual listener, that's not going to mean anything. You know, ups and downs, smiles and frowns. No, that is directed at someone in particular. I'm going to tell you who that's directed to. Let's break this down.
I don't smile. I don't frown. Get too up or get too down.
I don't smile. I don't frown. Get too up or get too down. Snoop Dogg had a song, Ups and Downs. In the hook of that song, he talks about the ups and the downs, the smiles and the frowns. And you might say, oh, no, that's not necessarily Snoop. That could be very generalized. Next lines are key. Check this.
I don't smile. I don't frown. Get too up or get too down. I was here. So were you. You came and went. I stuck around. Still here.
I was here. So were you. We both came up in this rap game. Except you went. You are no longer relevant. Me? I have this longevity. I'm still in the game. That is where it ties into Snoop. Ooh, he's firing shots. I would put money on that. I would put money on that.
I was here, so were you. You came and went. I stuck around. Still here now. Stop me how your opinion's like a broken calculator. That shit doesn't count. Shut your motherfucking mouth. I'm empty and
oh, shit. He didn't stop there. All of those lines are at Snoop. He carried that over. Your opinion doesn't count because Snoop came out in that Charlamagne interview on Insta and talked about his top 10 rappers and lyricists and how the hood doesn't play M. The hood doesn't bump M. They don't relate to him. And M is basically saying, look, man, your opinion doesn't count anymore. It's like a broken calculator because a broken calculator can't count numbers. Same as your opinion.
Oh, I'm getting all the like vibes.
That's right.
I'm getting all the like vibes.
This is, yeah, yeah. You get them all the like vibes on this one.
You're getting all the like vibes on this one. Boy. Y'all know what time it is. Ah, oh, there's some heat.
There's some heat.
Haven't used all the tricks I have, so like my balls, I'm in my bag. Get a little testy when I'm mad. Sick of wrestling this iPad.
It's gonna be a long video already. He said, I haven't used all of my tricks and like my balls, I'm in my bag. Like literally like my bag of tricks, but also his testicles, like they're in the, I don't know if you would call it a bag, but it's a scrotum. That's why he says, I get a little testy when I'm mad. Like people like to push my buttons. Don't push my buttons. I get a little testy, but testy's like balls. Yeah.
Haven't used all the tricks I have, so like my balls, I'm in my bag. Get a little testy when I'm mad. Sick of wrestling this iPad.
I heard that getting a little testy, like I'm getting a little upset, but he said, balls in my bag, testy, like your testicles are in the nut sack, which is also referred to as a ball. Haven't used all the tricks I have, still got some more balls in my bag or some shit, because like magicians be having hella fucking balls, like them little red balls they can squeeze tight in their hand and move all this, that. You be thinking it's like two in here, but he be like fucking 1,000 this motherfucker, because he got balls hidden everywhere. Little magic bag, but he's also talking about balls and a nutsack, you know what I'm saying? And he said, I get a little testy when I'm mad, but testes are testicles, but testes, I get a little impatient. I will snap on you, a little testy when I'm mad. Come on, M.
Haven't used all the tricks I have. I still like my balls, I'm in my bag. I get a little testy when I'm mad. Sick of wrestling this iPad. Unsuccessfully.
Like my balls, I'm in my bag. I get a little testy.
Testicles balls in my bag. Yeah, okay.
Yeah, I'm with the balls bars.
Yeah, we know he gonna have them.
Time just to come in on shit. Especially shit you don't like. Don't like it, don't listen. But don't tell me about your favorite rapper ripping some shit he didn't write. What happened to Slim?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, what's the point of fucking wasting time commenting on shit that you don't like? If you don't like listening to it, if you don't like it, don't listen to it. But what's the point of commenting shit telling me about your favorite rapper who don't even write? Ooh, that's a bow, 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 bow. I wonder what rappers he's talking about. Bow, bow. I wonder what rappers he's talking about. Eminem want all the smoke. He a fucking chimney in this bitch. He want all the fucking smoke. Let's go.
Internet, I need to get on the mic. Get on the mic. You need to get off the internet. Internet, you need to get you alive. Why waste time just to come in on shit? Especially shit you don't like. Don't like it, don't listen. But don't tell me about your favorite rapper ripping some shit he didn't write. What happened to
Don't tell me about your favorite rapper if it's some shit that he didn't write, dog. You can't talk shit about my shit when your favorite artist has a ghostwriter. Like, who the fuck are you to comment on whether or not my music is good when your favorite artist's music isn't even good that for him to write his own shit? But he said, why waste your time just to comment on shit, especially if you don't like? Like, if you don't like what I'm putting out, if you don't like what I'm saying, change the channel. Like, why are people in such arms about it? Just fucking don't listen to it. No one's got a gun to your head, listen, like requiring that you play Marshall Mathers LP 24/7, you know?
Why you waste time just to come in on shit? Especially shit you don't like. Don't like it, don't listen, but don't tell me about your favorite rapper ripping some shit he didn't write. What happened to Slim? He was no cap at the pen. He used to rap like the people his music was for. He was exactly like them.
Ooh, yeah. Yeah, he even went into character on y'all. What happened to Slim? What happened to him? He used to rap for the people that were just like him. What happened to him? That's how y'all be sounding. Y'all be wanting just like, what happened to Slim? Where's Slim Shady? Oh yeah, M say he hear it all, man.
Shit you don't like, don't like it, don't listen, but don't tell me about your favorite rapper ripping some shit he didn't write. What happened to Slim? He was no cap at the pen. He used to rap like the people his music was for. He was exactly like them.
He was no cap at the pen, like not lying. But a pen cap as well. Like, he had the cap off the pen. He was always writing. He was letting it out. He was honest. He was open. He wouldn't lie. And then what happened to Slim? What happened to the old M? Well, the old M was poor as shit. The old M wrote Rock Bottom. The old M didn't have any money and talked about those things and talked about that struggle and that poverty and that come up. This new M is now a multimillionaire. So you can't expect him to talk about the same things that he talked about on the come up, because his world has changed. His life has changed. Dramatically. Wow, that is a cool word that does not exist in the English dictionary. He's already just twirling my brain around.
He was exactly like them. Like the dude who used to be poor. Why can't he tap into him? Can't use that excuse anymore. He's mad at the wind. He's in a nuclear war. With a cloud, he's yelling at it again.
He's in a nuclear war. Okay. That kind of reminded me of what MGK said too. Like, you rich as fuck, why you mad as fuck? You know what I'm saying? He mad as fuck because motherfucker's still disrespecting his fucking name. You know what I'm saying? Like LeBron said, when LeBron won his fourth fucking ring, you got anything to say, LeBron? Yeah, I want my fucking respect. That's all Eminem is mad about, because he wants his fucking respect, because what he has accomplished in his hip hop game, nobody else has accomplished. So the mere fact the motherfucker's still hating on me is gonna piss me off. That's why the fuck I'm mad as fuck in the world, because y'all disrespecting me. Y'all ain't put no motherfucking respect on my name. And that's true to him, that's genuine. If he was supposed to go tap back into the old Slim when he was broke saying relatable shit, that'd be a lie, because that's not his life anymore. You rap about your perception. You gotta fucking rap about what you live in. And Eminem's rapping about what he's living. And what his main issue is that motherfuckers don't put respect on his goddamn name. And that's the pocket that I love Eminem rapping in, because that means he gonna talk his shit and prove to y'all that y'all need to be putting respect on my name, because can't nobody else out here do what the fuck I do. Facts. Can't nobody else out here do what the fuck I do. God damn it.
Sick was poor. He was exactly like them. Like the dude who used to be poor. Why can't he tap into him? Can't use that excuse anymore. He's mad at the wind. He's in a nuclear war. With the cloud, he's yelling at it again.
He's in a nuclear war with the cloud. He's yelling at it again. And he said he can't use that. He's mad at the wind. Like Eminem. Like that's something that people always say. Oh, he's mad at everybody. He's mad at mumble rap. He's mad at people that come at him. He's mad at MGK still. Still mad at Ja Rule. Like, that's just the nature of his personality. He's that aggressive. He's that competitive where it always seems like he's mad, even if he's not.
I talked to your mother. She told me she loved me. All she wanted to do was just hold me and hug me. Once nobody but me, she showed me the Dougie. Can I get a witness like Notary Public? She said kick some flash.
Ooh, can I get a witness like Notary Public? I talked to your mama too. She showed me the Dougie. Oh, God.
Yelling at it again. I talked to your mother. She told me she loved me. All she wanna do is just hold me and hug me. Once nobody but me, she showed me the Dougie. Can I get a witness like Notary Public? She said kick some fly.
He talk about your mama. All these motherfucking haters. This is the metaphoric mother to all the fucking haters that he's had. Like, I'm talking to your mama. You ain't hating on me, I'm talking to your mama. Your mama wanna love me and hug me. She teach me the Dougie, the fucking dance. Can I get a witness? Like a Notary Public preach. You know, how the preacher say, can I get a witness? Because the preacher is preaching. So he's saying preach, but Notary Public need a fucking notary to witness like an official document. You know what I'm saying? So he just talking shit. He just saying, I can do whatever I want to do with your mama. You know what I'm saying?
Me the Dougie, can I get a witness? Yeah. Like Notary Public preach. She said kick some fly shit. Fly.
Can I get a note? Can I get a witness like Notary Public? Like, can I get a witness to this fucking shit that I'm spitting over here? And a Notary Public is literally a witness who watches people sign signatures to make sure that it's authentic, you know?
Said kick some fly shit. I said I got wings on my wings ass. Told him my dick's a cockpit. I fly by the seat of my pants. Simple thought.
My dick is a cockpit. Dick to cock. You see that tie-in? But also kick some fly shit. Like, kick something that's fly. Well, An airplane is fly. A cockpit is on an airplane. That's fly. See where he's going with this? And then the saying, flying by the seat of your pants.
On my ass. Told her my dick's a cockpit. I fly by the seat of my pants.
I told her my dick is the cockpit. So it's a whole flying thing. But she said, kick some fly shit. I got wings on my ass. Fly, wing, cockpit. It's a whole flying scheme. But basically saying he wants the cockpit, the pit of him where his cock is. And he wants your mama on his cock. Come fly with me on this cop. You know what I'm saying? I take you on a flight with this cop. But the whole airplane scheme, let's go.
Sinful thoughts, this beat is crazy. This shit's retarded, this sense just minimal.
Ooh, hold up. Yeah, shit is crazy, this beat retarded, this instrumental. This ish is mental. Instrumental, mental, retarded. Come on, M.
Sinful thoughts, this beat is crazy. This shit's retarded, this sense just minimal. Too many bars, incidental charges.
Yo, this beat is crazy. This instra is mental. This instrumental, instra is mental, like mentally off its rocker. This beat is crazy, dog. It's fucking fire. And the way that he like says his instra is mental and then like lets it breathe so your brain has time to figure out what he just said and then goes on into the next one, dog.
Sinful thoughts, this beat is crazy. This shit's retarded. This instra is mental. Too many bars,
No, he didn't. No, he didn't. This beat is crazy. Shit's retarded. This instrumental. Instrumental is what we call a beat. It's an instrumental. But he's also saying, like, this instru is mental. This beat is crazy. It's mental. Wow. I've never thought about it in that way. That is a dope way to pick apart that bar.
This beat is crazy. This shit's retarded. This instru's mental. Too many bars. Incidental charges. When did it start? I've been called.
Best wordplay so far, I would say. Too many bars and incidental charges. Can I speak today, Knox? Can you talk today? I got this. All right, mini bars because a hotel bill, you give me your card for incidental charges. That includes anything that you take from the mini bar. So too many bars, mini bars, incidental charges, but also M-A-N-Y, too many. He has a plethora of bars and he breaks people's brains.
Simple thoughts, this beat is crazy. This shit's retarded, this is just mental. Too many bars, incidental charges. When did it?
Too many bars.
Mini bars,
incidental. Too many bars, incidental charge. Up. What you talking about?
What you talking about?
Too many bars, incidental charges. You know how you get incidental charges in the hotel? The mini bars.
Drink me some water from my own mini one. Too many bars.
That was crazy.
Incidental charges.
Mini bars. Incidental. That was a bar.
That was a bar.
That was a bar.
It was a bar.
I used to wonder where my next meal's gonna come from.
Before, he was hungry, didn't know where he's gonna find his next meal. Now he just wanna eat all these fucking rappers out here, and he wants to know who's up for him to eat. If that wasn't it, he did a lot more there. See, Eminem get on my fucking nerves, bro. He always do this shit to me, bro. Did he mean what I thought he meant? Cause Mill, M-E-A-L, and M-I-L-L are like totally opposite in how he's using it. I used to wonder when my next meal was gonna come from, as in food. Now, since I'm so rich, I get millions all the time, I'm wondering where my next $1 million is gonna come from. Or he could be, because the first thing I thought was just talking shit type shit. Like, I'm out here trying to kill everybody in this rap shit. So who's up for me to eat my next meal like that? Like my rapper meal. But nah, I don't think he's talking about that. I think I just automatically assumed he was saying that. I think he's talking about M-I-L-L-I-O-N, like meal, like $1 million. $1 million. I just have that werewolf mentality for him. I'm like, I just want him to fuck everybody up. And that's what this song is talking about. I'm trying to fuck everybody up. I'm the best. Y'all motherfuckers is lunch meat. Y'all motherfuckers is meatloaf, like 50 said. Let's go.
Make it. I get to remind all the haters. Shitted on me when I'm on my way. My floor is y'all food ceilings. If I was you, I would step or find yourself twisted. That's how you wind up like spiral stairs. I will swear on a stack of Bibles. I will tear new behinds out of rivals, even your idols. I don't care. It's music to be murdered by. So, but if air can swallow a fucking gyro, bobblehead and that slow like all time. Lone sniper.
Hold on, dog.
My floor is y'all food ceilings. If I was you, I would step or find yourself twisted. That tire wind up like spiral stairs. I will swear on a stack of Bibles. I will tear new
That's how you'll wind up. Like, that's how you'll end up. But also, spiral stairs, literally, they wind up as the staircase goes up.
I'll wind up like spiral stairs. I will swear on a stack of Bibles. I will tear new behinds out of rivals, even your idols. I don't care. It's me.
I love that irony. I will swear on a stack of Bibles, like swearing, cursing, but also like swearing on the Bible, like giving your testimony. So he's using swear in two different ways there, and the irony of swearing on the Bible, cursing on it.
Stairs, I will swear on a stack of Bibles. I will tear new behinds out of rivals, even your idols. I don't care. It's music to be murdered by. So, but if air can swallow a fucking gyro, bobblehead and that slow like all time.
Bon Iver. Is it Bon Iver or Bon Iver? I don't know much about the group. But anyways, that dude was on Fall. But when he dropped Fall, he had that Tyler, the Creator diss. And I'm just going to say what he used. He used faggot, right? And that just got him into a lot of trouble, a lot of media shitstorm. Bon Iver comes out, tweets about it, that he asked to be pulled off of it. The label wouldn't let him pull off, so his name is not with it. He doesn't want to be associated with it. So this is finally M coming back and firing at that fact, at Fall. Wow. And he puts him in the same class as Ja Rule. Why you got to do that, M? I mean, Ja Rule is still in Shaq's toilet. So now you're putting Bon Iver in there too?
I will swear on a stack of Bibles. I will tear new behinds out of rivals, even your idols. I don't care. It's music to be murdered by. So Bon Iver can swallow a fucking Ja Rule bobblehead and that slow like
oh, shit. Oh, Lord. Oh, Ja Rule. Nah, I've been hearing things. I ain't know if it was this song, but Ja Rule, your time has come.
Lone sniper, I hold the microphone like a loaded rifle. My dome's brighter, all I spit from my skull's fire. All that's missing's a motorcycle with the chrome wire. Smoke tires and y'all a flow biter, so I don't gotta explain why they call me your ghost rider. I'm empty and
yo, y'all are flow biters, so I don't have to explain why they call me your ghost rider, dog. Like, even if I'm not the one handing you verses, like, even if I'm not straight up being a ghost rider, you're biting my flow so much, I might as well be your ghost rider. That's clean. And he said, lone sniper, I hold the microphone like a loaded rifle, ready to just aim it at anybody who wants this. He said, my dome is brighter, all I spit from this skull is fire. Like, literally, he's sharper, he's smarter than you, his rhymes are smarter than you. But also, his skull is on fire and fire bright, like, just the way he switched both of those phrases in and out. It's dope. And then he goes on to completely finish the wordplay about, well, what's the name of the, it's with Nicolas Cage. Ghost Rider? Oh, shit! It just clicked up here, dog. Holy fuck. You're witnessing me, like, realize a bar way after the fact when I normally do. Yo, all right, so the fucking skull's brighter. My dome's on fire. Skull's brighter, like my mom's smarter than you. And then all that I'm missing is the fucking motorcycle with the chrome wires and spoke tires. I don't got to explain to you why I'm your ghost rider. But like ghost rider, like with a pen, but ghost rider, like a motorcycle, like the cartoon character Ghost Rider who had the fucking skull on fire. Holy fuck, that was a bar. Yo. I can't believe how much of a fucking bar that was and how late that I got it.
Blown sniper, I hold the microphone like a loaded rifle. My dome's brighter, all I spit from my skull's fire. All that's missing's a motorcycle with the chrome wire. Smoke tires and y'all a flow biter. So I don't gotta explain why they call me your ghost rider. I'm in...
With the Ghost Rider scheme? You gonna do it with the Ghost Rider scheme?
What are you talking about?
What are you talking about right now?
That Ghost Rider scheme.
He said my skull's flaming. Only
skull's
thing,
flaming.
Only thing
what he's missing is the motorcycle.
Fight for my dome's brighter. All I spit from my skull's fire. All that's missing's a motorcycle with the chrome wire. Smoke tires and y'all a flow biter. So I don't gotta explain why they call me your ghost rider. I'm emptying. I'm emptying.
Fuck you, Eminem. Wow, that was crazy. He just spent four lines setting up a Ghost Rider scheme. So basically, what he's saying here is he paints the picture of the Marvel character of Nicolas Cage, Ghost Rider, right? Riding the motorcycle, chromed out everything. The head is on fire. Like, I thought he was taking it as like his rap is on fire, his head's on fire, what he's thinking. But actually, he took that and did a visual metaphor and a double with it, with actually being the Ghost Rider. So that character, and then also him being a Ghost Writer. W-R-I-T-E-R. Y'all are flow biters. I don't have to explain. So basically what he's saying is that he is a ghost. Oh my God. That is a crazy line. He's a ghost writer. He's y'all's ghost writers. Basically, you know, you haven't asked him to be your ghost writer, but he is serving as your ghost writer because you are biting his flow and his style and everything that he is in the game. I like the way you put that, man. That's dope.
Them flips the ass and kiss the crack. Spit your damnedest. You're still gonna hit the canvas. Ripping rappers, veterans to whippersnappers. Mr. Mathis is killing this shit. Villainous whip with scantless. Syllables rip the planet. Biblical shit's finna hit the fan. Anybody wanna go tit for tat's gonna get hit with that. Then the amygdala hippocampus is gonna trigger the ignoramus to think of the most ridiculous shit to spit. Then pit it against these pitiful rappers and.
This beat is hard as shit. This shit wearing me out, bro. Whew. Ooh, hold on.
Gift to gab and pin to pad, throw temper tantrums into anthem, for lips to ass and kiss.
Throw temper tantrums into anthems. Like, even when it seems like he's being a toddler and he's being petty, he's still taking that energy and he's making great music and art out of it, which is so true. So many great Eminem songs come from when he is just so pissed off. The Way I Am, one of the greatest songs of all time. He is nothing but mad in that and fueled.
Put lips to ass and kiss the crack. Spit your damnedest. You're still gonna hit the canvas. Ripping rappers, veterans to whippers.
He's like, spit your damnedest. You're still gonna hit the canvas.
Look, he's like, you can kiss all the ass you want. You can spit the best. You're still gonna hit the canvas, which means when you know hit the canvas means you're gonna get knocked out. The canvas is the boxing ring. When a fighter hit the canvas, that means he's knocked out. So you can spit your bars. You can kiss as much ass as you want, but you still getting knocked out because I am the one.
Been rappers, veterans to whippersnappers. Mr. Mathis is killing this shit. Villainous whip with scantless. Syllables rip the planet. Biblical shit's finna hit the fan. Anybody wanna go tit for tat's gonna get hit with that. Then he...
Oh, wow. That made me think of his best friend flow right there. Fill up a syllable clip. You know when he really hits that hard, that scheme?
Ooh. Syllables rip the planet. Biblical shit's finna hit.
Syllables for the rip the planet. Biblical shit. I like that.
Scantless syllables rip the planet. Biblical shit's finna hit the fan. Anybody wanna go tit for tat's gonna get hit with that. Then the amygdala hippocampus is gonna trigger the ignorant.
Syllables rip the planet. Syllables rip the planet. Syllables rip the planet. Come on, dog.
Patro temper tantrums into anthem. For lips to ass and kiss the crack. Spit your damnedest. You're still gonna hit the canvas. Ripping rappers, veterans to whippersnappers.
Bruh, he said spit your damnedest. He spit your damnedest. It don't matter. I'm gonna turn veterans into whippersnappers. It don't matter. Oh, that's the shit I fucking like. That's the shit I fucking like. I don't give a fuck who you are. You could be a vet in this shit. Think you the best. Think you the best? I will turn your veteran thinking face ass into a whole whippersnapper out here. Whippersnapper like a young ass. Yo, little young ass whippersnapper. They don't know nothing about nothing. They just young motherfuckers don't know shit about nothing. He would turn a vet. He would make a vet, you know, rewind back into some young shit compared to what the fuck he can spit, dog. Let's go. Let's go.
Syllables rip the planet. Biblical shit's finna hit the fan. Anybody wanna go tit for tat's gonna get hit with that. Then the amygdala hippocampus is gonna trigger the ignoramus to think of the most ridiculous shit to spit, then pit it against these pitiful rappers. Insidious. These idiots witty as shit against me. Shitty as MC Hammers.
Dog, shitty as MC Hammers. But yo, really the real bar that stands out right here is the way that he uses like part of the brain and then calling stupid people ignoramuses to fit the rhyme scheme. And then he said the amygdala hippocampus is gonna trigger the ignoramuses to pit it against me with these pitiful rappers, dog. Like, I'm gonna be spitting that shit. And then that section in your brain, the section in your brain that instinctively awakens that fight or flight response. It's like an instinct within you. Are you a flight person or are you a fight person? You're gonna run or you're gonna, like, that section, when they hear my rhymes, that part of their brain is gonna get triggered and they're gonna try to come at me and they don't have the skill to come at me and they're gonna get buried.
Ban, anybody wanna go tit for tat's gonna get hit with that. Then the amygdala hippocampus is gonna trigger the ignoramus to think of the most ridiculous shit.
Holy shit. The amygdala hippocampus is gonna trigger the ignoramus. Wow. So the amygdala is responsible for, that's the flight or flight. Yeah, that's the emotive part of the brain, figuring out the emotional responses. And that also communicates with the hippocampus, because if something like traumatic or emotional happens, the hippocampus controls your memory, right? So the two and two tie in with each other. When things happen to you emotionally, triggers your memory to remember it. I love how he used triggers there, like being triggered, triggering people. So he's triggering ignoramuses, but also playing off of that imagery of the amygdala triggering the hippocampus. And then also his craziness is that he is hitting you in two different places. He's hitting your emotions. He's hitting your flight or flight, your fight or flight response. And he's also hitting your memory. So he is doing damage to all levels of your brain and my brain as well.
The ignoramus to think of the most ridiculous shit to spit, then pit it against these pitiful rappers. Insidious, these idiots, witty as shit against me. Shitty as MC Hammers.
These rappers' most insidious shit against me is MC Hammer, because MC Hammer's not a bar heavy rapper. They can take they most bar heavy shit for their bars heavy standards, put it against me. They shit gonna sound like MC Hammer when you hear what the fuck I got to say. Facts.
The trick of the ignoramus to think of the most ridiculous shit to spit, then pit it against these pitiful rappers. Insidious, these idiots, witty as shit against me. Shitty as MC Hammers. Get your whole squad, send a task force.
This is second like time, you know what I'm saying? In that second time, he done mentioned Hammer.
MC Hammer, dog.
What done popped off with him and Hammer, yo?
He said these idiots, witty as shit, is shitty as MC Hammers. They best shit is shitty as MC Hammer. That mean your best shit is my worst shit. Your best shit ain't even better than my worst shit.
You can't touch this.
You can't touch this.
Is gonna trigger the ignoramus to think of the most crazy shit to spit, then pit it against these pitiful rappers. Insidious, these idiots, witty as shit against me. Shitty as MC Hammers.
Oh no, he kind of dissed MC Hammer there, but I'm sorry, MC Hammer is like Dr. Seuss style rhymes compared to what he just did on that scheme. That was the most ridiculous scheme of the whole track so far, and there's been so many ridiculous schemes, but that just internal delivery and rhymes. Wow.
Idiots, witty as shit against me. Shitty as MC Hammers. Get your whole squad, send a task force in. If you want it, you about to get what you asked for then. Put your helmet on, strap your chin. You about to get you a crash course in. Who not to start a motherfucking rap war with?
Strap your helmet in. You about to fucking get a crash course of who you should not start a war against, bruh. Or start a war with. Or start a war like you don't want no smoke. You about to understand. You are about to understand why you do not want no fucking smoke with Eminem, bruh. Eminem, bruh. 50 years old talking like this shit,
bruh. Hold on. City is MC Hammers. Get your whole squad, send a task force in. If you want it,
get your whole squad, send a task force in. Get your whole team. Get your whole team. Get the specialty units of your team. Send the motherfuckers you think are the most equipped to deal with my smoke, to deal with my shit. Send them in. I'm gonna eat them like fucking hotcakes.
City is MC Hammers. Get your whole squad, send a task force in. If you want it, you about to get what you asked for then. Put your helmet on, strap your chin. You about to get you a crash course in. Who not to start a motherfucking rap war with or to go against? Fuck what you wanna do that for, no offense. But are you retard, slow or dense? A fucking penny has more sense. Yeah, now you...
at niggas, are you niggas slow or dense? Are you niggas slow or stupid? He said, even a penny got more sense. Oh my God. Even a penny got more sense? Oh my, man, this nigga ill, bro, stop.
I feel like I'm an automobile with Barnacle Bill inside the car at the wheel, inside a carnival, cause I'm plowing into everyone who wrote snotty articles, and that explains why the fuck you clowns are all in my grill. Joy and pain, fortune, fame, torture, shame, choice I made, swore someday, the world to pay, less to lose, more to gain, daughters raised, yesterday, glory days, adored and praised, ignored the hate, addressed the fake, toured with Dre, tore a page from Jordan Kane, destroyed the game, before you came, enjoy your stay, before it's gone away, but the more you claim, that you're gonna point and name, if you join the gang, your shit isn't going to bang, you're just boring, lame, and more of the same, you have an enormous chain, but a stormless brain, the most you can form is rain, your shit is pointless, ain't. But the more you claim that you're gonna point and name, if you join the gang, your shit isn't going to bang. You're just boring, lame, and more of the same. You have an enormous chain, but a stormless brain. The most you can form is rain. Your shit.
Wow, you have an enormous chain, right? So you have all this money that you're bragging about, and he's definitely speaking to like some of the newer age rappers. But a stormless brain. You can't brainstorm. You can't be creative. You can't be clever. The most you can form is rain. Like, not a whole on thunderstorm, not a whole wild brainstorm. All you can do is rain in terms of making it rain, relating to the chain. All you care about is materialism. You are not in this music for the art, to be the best MC that you can be. You're just in it for the sales. I like the way he's painted that picture.
More you claim that you're gonna point and name. If you join the gang, your shit isn't going to bang. You're just boring, lame, and more of the same. You have an enormous chain, but a stormless brain. The most you can form is rain. Your shit is pointless, same as a scoreless game. So bitch, quit lying. You're denying like Mr. Porter's name. Borderline bipolar disorder.
You're denying like Mr. Porter's name, dog? Talking about, what the fuck is his stage name? Obviously, Mr. Porter is one of them, but he goes by something else. Con artist is what he goes by. But denying the truth. But denying is his name. It's clean.
Like Mr. Porter's name. Borderline bipolar disorder since my stroller. Eyes swollen in back of my skull like Eli Porter. Fire mortar.
Eyes swollen in the back of my skull like Eli Porter. On YouTube when he was doing the rap battles, and the dude just did all these like crazy mannerisms and stuff and had his eyes roll in the back of his head. Alright, keep
Porter's going. Name, borderline bipolar disorder since my stroller, eyes rolling back of my skull like Eli Porter, fire mortar, rounds I told every eye or the eye loader.
Fire mortar rounds, right? He's got that ammunition. And then I think he said I told her. Like, you know, we're getting into Muslim religion now, and that's like religious leaders. So he's saying like he's close to God. All right.
My book arrives. My book arrives. I'm
Eastside. Dog, do you realize how hard it is to do that, to like find the scratch and find exactly that same place every single time? I mean, I know DJs, especially at the level of DJ Premier, or even just like, you know, above average DJs at scratching. I know they have like sectioned off they have sectioned off on their vinyl where they can like see where to hit, or at least it gives them a visual reference point. But DJ Premier don't need that shit anymore. He's way past that level. But just to go back and hit I'm East Side, just to go back to that same I'm without going too far or coming too far under the I'm.
Damn, he is so dope. Yo, I mean, right, to take the record, the turntable, and to scratch it, and to do it with vocals is so hard, especially what he's doing, like hitting the same vocals, because you got to hit that same spot on the record scratch, man. Appreciate Primo's skill one more time to take us out. That is dope, man. That is true hip-hop, the old days of MCing right there with the DJ, the turntablism and the MCing together, married in one, man. It's beautiful. I love how M always pays homage to hip-hops and to the greats.